notice I didn't use the minus function, but the negative 32. X is right here, x, and then we're going to square it. And then we're going to divide by 130 squared. Just following that, close my parentheses, and then we're going to just add x. Okay, now once we do that, we can answer these questions by going over here to the table. I'll clear out this work by hitting delete. Remember, you have to set up the table here. Let me show you. Second table has to be set to ask here so you can do this. Second table, otherwise there'll be numbers here you can't delete. Now I can just see when they want 100 feet, I can put 100 in here, and it will tell me the answer right there, 81.065. It says round to two decimal places, so 81.07 according to this. Let me take a look at that number, 81.07. Yeah, so we should be able to put it right in here, 81.07. Let's see what happens. It's just a matter here of going down. They want 300. We've got a table here, so I can put 300 in for the table for x, and we can answer it again, 129.59. Let me make sure that's rounded correctly. 129.59, that's going to go in here. So we'll do that. We'll do 129.59. See how we did. Maybe I did something wrong there. Let me take a look at the 129.59. I think I put a comma in there. That's why I messed up. Let's see if it's, that's my problem. I think it is 129.59. Yeah, I had used a comma there. I'm glad that happened to show you. It might not be that your number is wrong. Maybe you put a comma instead of a period. And I think we got one more of those to do here. So we'll just put in 400 over here. So I'm just using the calculator to do this using that table method here. And now we have 97.041. Notice how I use the cursor to put it on there, 97.041 or 0.04 when we round it to two decimal places. So 97.04. Let's make sure to use the correct punctuation, 97.04. Okay, let's see if we get that right. Okay, so you can see I'm just using the table here, and that's second. The table is right up there. Don't forget, to do this, you have to have your window, your table set to say ask right there. Otherwise, you won't be able to put in your own numbers. Okay, and here, take a look at my y equals again, too, so I can show you what it looks like there for my function. Okay. Next, they want to know, at a height of 400 feet, what is the golf ball traveled to? Okay, so we want to go ahead and go to y equals where we are, and we want to put in, at a height of 400 feet, what is the distance the ball traveled to? So we'll put in 400 here for the x or for the y, and then when we're going to have to graph it. So to graph this thing, what we want to do is we want to set our window equal to 0, and then we'll set this one equal to, let's go ahead and do 900, and then this one we'll set the y minimum to 0, and then we'll set the y maximum to say 200. See if that works, and then I'm going to hit graph. Okay, take a look at my window. 0 to 900, 0 to 200. When I hit graph, I should see the golf ball go up and come down. I do. And then when I come back here and I go to y equals, I can put that 400 in, and you should see 400 come across here at some point. Let's see. Okay, so what they're asking for here is the h of 400 is not the height of 400. It's the height of the golf ball after it has traveled a distance of 400. So we can still use the table for that. So we'll come back to the table and I'll come down, put in the 400, and I got 97.04 feet right here. So I think that's the same. Let's get that deleted out of there. I think that's still 97.04 that we had right up there. Yeah, okay, so now that's good. The golf ball, how far was the golf ball hit? Well, if we go back here, notice that I had put the 400 here. That's not a good thing to put there because the golf ball is not going that high. But we can do a 0 here so that when we graph it, we actually have the golf ball going up. Now here's the line, y equals 0, so this is where it hits the ground. And watch this carefully. Now, second, calculate the intersection, number 5. That was second. that little cursor down close to where we're going to hit the ground. You can see some values here, but all you have to do is hit enter three times. 1, 2, 3. That's actually answering the questions. It will tell you it went 528.125 feet, rounded to two decimal places, 528.13. Notice that they tell you to use 0 to 600 and 0 to 140. So let's pull our calculator back out and go to our window and make sure you put in 0 to 600. And I have 900. I'm going to change it to 600. Okay, and it also tells you 0 to 140. So I'm going to go 0 to 140 here. That's just so I can put the same values they have here. And when I hit graph, I should be able to determine which one of these graphs is correct. Okay, so let's see what we got here. Well, it depends. Kind of looking like this one most well. It's hard to say because we should probably look at the blown up version of this thing. Certainly looks like it could be this one. Let's give this a shot and see. Yeah, okay. All right, so when the ball is 100 feet, okay, so let's look at 100 feet here. Put 100 in for the Y, and then we can hit graph again. Notice I put 100 because it says using a graphing utility, that's this. How high is it when the ball is 100 feet? Okay, so I put 100 in there. As you can see now, here's the ball, and I can see there's two places. It goes up past 100, and it comes back down. So I want to know those two places, so I'll hit second, calculate the intersection number 5, and then I'll just move that cursor over to the first one. Well, that's 133.9999. It says round to two decimal places. I think that is rounded to two decimal places is 134. So we'll put 134 right here. It's not the only one though, so let's not hit enter yet. 134, comma this time. Make sure you don't hit a parenthesis. We'll go back this time and we'll hit second, calculate the intersection number 5. And let's go to the other side. Like 394.12, so 394.13. Let's see how that works in here. So we'll do 394.13. And let's see if we're lucky enough to get that right there. Yeah. Okay. So there you have it. That's one way we can go ahead and